gather in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. We come to that point in our service where we just reflect on the week, the relationships around us, the encounters we've had. We think of those times where we've thought or said or done something we regret, but then hold on to the truth that Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, we can rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart to him. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate faults. We are wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past and lead us out from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. It's God who does the forgiving, therefore we sing a Gloria as the angels do. Gladden the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord. Give us such knowledge of his presence with us, that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life, and serve you continually in righteousness and in truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Do please be seated for our first reading this morning, which is taken from Acts.
Reading from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verses 14a, 36 to 41. But Peter, standing with the 11, lifted up his voice and addressed them. Let all the house of Israel therefore know, assuredly, that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, Brethren, what shall we do? And Peter said to them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is to you and to your children and to all that are far off, every one of whom the Lord our God calls to him. And he testified with many other words and exhorted them, saying, Save yourselves from this crooked generation. So those who received his word were baptized, and there were added to that day about 3,000 souls. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. In response to God's word, we stand and sing hymn number 543, When a Knight Won His Spurs. According to Luke. On that same day, two of the disciples were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, What are you discussing with each other while you walk along? They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days? Jesus asked him, What things? They replied, The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty indeed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find the body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus. Then they said to him, and then he said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, "Stay with us, because it is almost evening and the day is now nearly over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and he gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized Jesus, and he vanished from their sight. And they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scripture to us?" That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, "The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon." Then they told what had happened on the road and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. This is the gospel of the Lord. I did promise you no sermon, and I meant it, but I do want to highlight a few things from the reading. Do please be seated. I promise there is no big talk. I just want you to imagine, though, because this is set on Easter Sunday still. They've killed Jesus, the women have been to the tomb, they've spoken about what they saw, and now we arrive on this journey to Emmaus. One of the things I think that struck me was that these people were anonymous to start with, they weren't named. But the bit that really stood out for me was they were walking away from Jerusalem. They were walking away from the cross, they were walking away from the tomb. Yet these people had heard the story the women had to tell. And actually, when it comes down to the crunch, they know exactly where the 11 disciples are. These are very, very close friends of Jesus, very well connected in with the disciples and the apostles, very well connected to the women. Otherwise, they wouldn't have had a clue what was going on. One of the things they said when they talked to Jesus was they hoped that he was the Redeemer of Israel. And it just made me think, as I unpack this, what is it we hope for? What is it we hope for? Because actually, hope is one of those things through which we'll guide our prayer. We've heard a story of a journey today at our APCM. A difficult story, a difficult journey. But actually, what our reading today reminds us of is that sometimes we can so be busy doing the doing, our eyes can be blinded from what God is doing around us. For those of you who do a jigsaw puzzle, how many of you do a jigsaw puzzle? Who cheats and looks at the box? How many of you spend your time looking at just one piece of that jigsaw puzzle? And looking at it going, "I've got to figure out where this piece goes, but I can't see where it goes." And you get frustrated, don't you? How many of you have thrown the jigsaw puzzle on the floor because you can't? Ridders. This is what Jesus is doing. He asks them to tell the story of who they are, what they have seen and what they have been. He's encouraging them to step back from the events of Holy Weekend, from the events of the cross and the events of the death of Jesus. He wants them to step away from the tomb and not just look at that piece, but look at the whole puzzle of how he's fulfilled it through the prophets from old
all the way through to today. And I'm sure he's sitting there with them going, I mean, it even says Jesus unfolded the scriptures to them and showed them, but they still couldn't see it. It's like, it's the box, it goes here. And they still couldn't see it. And actually, I think we can all be like that sometimes. We can be so worried about things happening around us that we can lose that sense of hope. Or maybe our hope is just in the wrong things. So what I want to encourage you today is not to journey on that road to Emmaus, away from the cross, away from the tomb, away from the disciples. I don't want you to journey home with that hope lost. I want you to think about journeying towards Jerusalem, towards the kingdom of God, with a hope in your heart, a burning passion for Jesus. Because that is what we're looking for this year as we go forward. It's people whose hearts are on fire for Jesus, so this church can thrive and continue to grow. And it will take workers and it will take people to help Sue with all of her warden jobs. It's going to take varying officers to do that. But God has already blessed this church over and over again. We just need to step back from it and look at the small blessings we've received and see how they fit together for that bigger puzzle, that bigger picture that God is building right here in Netherton. And if we can focus on what God is doing, if we can have that hope in our hearts that something better is going to come from this place, our hearts will burn with passion and we'll have a great story to tell. And that is my prayer for you and a prayer for this year ahead, that we, this church, have a story from the past which defines us, but we have a great story to tell in the future. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. There you go. I promise you it'll be a short one. It says that they knew Jesus in the breaking of the bread. So we're going to stand now and affirm our faith in Jesus, in God who is Trinity, his Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, with the words of the Creed on page 6. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Amen. Do please be seated for our prayers of intercession. Is anyone expecting to do the prayers of intercession? Merciful Father, as we gather here today, in this place, in this building, in the place known as Netherton Church, we pray, Lord, that this will be a church for the people of Netherton, a beacon of hope, of life, of peace, of love for them. We think about our world at this time. We remember all our brothers and sisters who gather together in the breaking of bread today and who are struggling, who face persecution from different governments, who meet in underground shelters because they are fearful of bombs. celebrate in prison because they have been wrongly arrested for their faith. We remember the injustices they are suffering, but ask you to strengthen them and give them a sense of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for our government at this time as they make difficult decisions about how they run our country. For corporations who put money before people. For the places where people are afraid. Places where people are hungry. For the needs of the community, we pray that our government will act justly for them. We pray for our local councillors as we face the election in the next few weeks. We pray that the people will be represented. We pray that the voices will be heard. We pray that government will be a place of honesty and integrity, where people stand for policies, not attacking people. Pray that all leaders, whether council or government, will have wisdom at this time and work for the good of all in our community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we remember those who are unwell at this time. We know there are many who are known to us and many who are unknown to us. We know that there are many reasons that people are struggling. We remember those who are the victims of modern slavery, those who are the victims of domestic abuse. Pray for them today as the government will send an emergency signal out. Wake up their phone that is hidden from their abuser. Bring awareness that they have been speaking to the people outside. Pray for your protection over them, your strength to rise up within them. Pray for those with hidden illnesses, Lord. Those who struggle with mental illnesses. Those who are in continual pain. Remember those who are named on our list with Reek William, John Hill, Jackie Inska, Sheila Homer, Danielle Gawley, Ray Cobb, Ben, Philip Stone, Brenda Paul, Helen and her friends and family, Carl Harris, Shirley Ducks, Shirley Lionel, Joe Hackett. We know the touch of your cloak was enough to bring healing, Lord, that no doctor could solve. And we just pray that healing touch upon all who reach for you, Lord. Your strength rise up within them, your love surround them, your peace be upon them, and your healing touch flow through them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Finally, Lord, we remember the friends and family of those who've departed. Remember the friends and family of Sylvia and of Colin Dunn. We ask you to give them a sense of peace during this time, a sense of purpose during their grief. And for those who have passed, may they rest in peace and rise in glory. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you stand for our peace, please? The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
We offer one another a sign of God's peace. And while you're standing, we'll save your knees a journey. Christ, our cornerstone, hymn number 77 in your books.
I see the sun, the moon, the stars.
May they be used to bring hope and joy and peace to the needs of the people in this community and beyond. Amen. As the grain scattered in these fields and the grapes once dispersed on the hillside are now reunited on this table in bread and wine, so, Lord, may your whole church soon be gathered together into your kingdom. Amen. We say together, yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. We'll continue on page 60. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Almighty God, good Father to us all, your face is turned towards your world. In love you gave us Jesus, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home, to the city where angels sing your praise. We join with them in heaven's song. Thanks for every gift that comes from heaven. To the darkness, Jesus came as your light with signs of faith and words of hope. He touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest. The crowds came out to see your son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to the table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest. Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it, and said, "This is my blood shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is our story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest. Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story. This is our song. Hosanna in the highest. Send your Holy Spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may be feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body,
because we all share in one bread.
Sacrifice for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Living God, your Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread. Open the eyes of our faith that we may see him in all his redeeming work, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. We continue with the prayer on the bottom of page 20. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Amen. Any notices looking around? Who's waving your hand frantically at me? Church without making me make it blush.
Hello all. I'm very happy and pleased to be with you today. My name is Yurika Faragi. I'm the candidate of Netherton. I'm standing first time, so as a councillor, and I wanted to come last Easter. unfortunately, I couldn't open the door, so it was first time. But I made this today, so I'm really happy to be here with you. And then we're looking forward to come more often. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, local elections are coming up. I think there's only one candidate up, isn't there, at the moment?
Yeah.
Is that right? So are you Conservative candidates?
Yes, I am.
Yeah. So you have the right to vote. Voting is a hard-fought-for right. And what I always say, these guys are people too, all right? These guys are beautifully made in God's image, and politics so often becomes about tearing people apart and not focusing on policies. So if you would like to know what the policies are of your potential candidate, then we'll set you up properly now. Tea and coffee will be available afterwards, but ask them, talk to them like they're human beings. Find out what their story is, because they will have one too about why they do what they do. Politics is a dirty business, I've become very aware of. And there's lots of accusations and lots of stories and lots of rumours, but when you talk to the actual people, you'll find out that they are just stories and rumours. So do please have a chat. Coffee and tea will be available afterwards. Hang on.
Thank you.
Hang on. next Sunday is Fifth Sunday, and we wouldn't normally have a service here, but it's APCM at St John's. So who would rather have a service of the word here? Put your hands up. Yeah. Oh, look at that. So Norman said he'll take a service of the word for us next week, so we'll be here at 10:30 as normal, if that's what you wish, okay? All okay? Any birthdays? Any birthdays? Anyone fessing up? No, all right, then we'll get cracking. We're already late. We're going to go with... he's going to empty the organ on this one. Hymn number 31, and did those feet in ancient times... Strengthen you to proclaim the word and works of God. And the blessing of God Almighty, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace of the risen Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.